A large explosion causes wood and metal debris to rise vertically in the air with an initial velocity of 96 feet per second. So for example, our explosion might look something like this. The polynomial equation, or more specifically, the quadratic equation given here, h equals 96t minus 16t squared, gives the height h in feet of the debris t seconds after the explosion. Part A, we want to use the given equation to find the height of the debris 4 seconds after the explosion. So for part A, we want to find h when t equals 4. So we'd have h equals 96 times 4 minus 16 times 4 squared. Well, 96 times 4 is equal to 384. And 4 squared is 16. 16 times 16 is equal to 256. So minus 256, this difference is 128. Let's go ahead and check this on the calculator. So we have 96 times 4 minus 16 times 4 squared. Here's the squared key and enter. So this verifies our value. Therefore, after 4 seconds, the height of the debris is 128 feet. For part B, we want to factor the right side of the given polynomial equation completely. So starting with the equation, h equals 96t minus 16t squared, we want to factor the right side completely. Remember, the first step in factoring is to factor out the greatest common factor. Notice both terms do contain a factor of t, so we also want to factor out the greatest common factor of 96 and 16. 96 is equal to 6 times 16, so let's write 96t as 6 times 16 times t. We'll write 16t squared as 16 times t times t. In this form, we can more easily identify the greatest common factor, which would be 16t. Notice both terms contain a factor of 16t. So now we'll factor out 16t. So we'll have h equals 16t times the quantity. If we factor out 16t from 96t, we're left with 6. If we factor out 16t from 16t squared, we're left with one factor of t. And now the right side of this equation is factored completely. But now that we do have this in factored form, I do want to point out that if we substituted 4 for t in the factored form, we would end up with the same value from part A. So let's go ahead and show that. If we substitute 4 for t in the factored form, we'd have 16 times 4 times, this would be 6 minus 4, or 2. Let's go ahead and check this in the calculator. We have 16 times 4 times 6 minus 4, or 2, is equal to 128. I hope you found this helpful.